You are welcome to the part 4 of this series. If you have missed any slide, you can refer to our YouTube. God bless you as you continue to listen.
Okay. So idols do what? They bring pollution. What do they bring? They bring pollutions. The Lord, they were saying that what? The believers should what? Should abstain from what? From the pollutions of what? Of idol. Let me now see the other one. 1 John 5:22. He said, what do you do, little children? Okay, it's 21, right? He said, what do you do? Brethren, if we want God, amen, to do what I've been telling you that God, so that how many of you? 10 of you, 100 shall chase how many? What do you do, little children? What did the Bible say? What does God say you should do? Keep yourself away from what? From idols. You know, sir, one of the worst things that have happened in the course of the fall and the attack is that most of our villages, our people have what? They have gone back to what? To idols to go and look for charms to protect themselves. You look for a charm and then you want to fight against which? Against the direct children of what? Worshippers of what? Of who? Of the devil himself. You are wasting your time. Have our charms helped us? So, brethren, if we want Jehovah to descend and fight for us, what must we do? We must what? We must keep ourselves away from what? From idols. From what? From idols. In the book of 2 Chronicles chapter 34, I know the because of time. You can read later. 2 Chronicles chapter 34, 35. Those two chapters. There is a man in chapter 34. They call him Josiah. He became a ruler at the age of 8 years. And Josiah grew up at the age of 12. And he grew. And he began to continue to rule. You know what Josiah did? There was trouble for Israel when he became king. It was horrible for him. You know that young man did? He knew where the problem came from. And what did he do? He knew that it was because his grandfather Manasseh have covered the land with what? With idol worship. Manasseh erected altars for Baal in the church, in the temple, both in the high place, everywhere. So the land was polluted so that when the enemy came, the people could not stand against the enemy. They couldn't fight the enemy. The same people of God. So Manasseh had to what? They say Manasseh purged the whole nation. When you read from verse 6, of 2 Chronicles 34. He said, and Manasseh purged the land of idols. He did what? He cut off all the idols from the land. Amen. And then Manasseh began to reign in victory. And no enemy came close to Egypt. I mean to Israel in the time of Manasseh. Because Manasseh had what? He had purged the land of idols. Hallelujah. Then another person again is a man called Gideon. You remember the man called Gideon? In Judges chapter 6 and 7. Judges went with how many people? With 300 men and what? And defeated an army of thousands. Army of different nations combined together. With 300 men only. What did God do? God defeated those army. How did it happen? When Gideon had an encounter with God, God told him, go and do what? Go and destroy the world, the idols of your father's house and of your land. And Gideon went by night and went and what? And destroyed all the idols in the land. Let me tell you, Domaland, as long as there are idols in your land, you will not be able to succeed in fighting against the Fulani Hills. You know why? Those idols that your people, your tribes, various tribes in Nasarawa State serve. I mean, all the tribes in Nasarawa State, there are idols your people serve. Is that not so? There are idols passing your land up to tomorrow. And I know that very well. In your various villages, there are people that worship idols. Do you know the masquerade here? Those masquerade, are they just masquerade? Who are they doing it for? For idols! They are worshiping idol with masquerade. As long as you have idol worship in Nasarawa State, you will not succeed against the Fulani Caliphate. What did I say? You will not succeed. If you want Jehovah to fight for you, purge your land like Josiah of what? Of idols. In 2 Chronicles 15, there's another king there called King Asa. In the time of King Asa, the people of God had trouble on every side. It was a horrible time for Judah. until when King Asa, after hearing the word of Asa, the son of Oded, this is what I'm talking to you now. King Asa now did what? He now purged the land of the idols, and they entered covenant not to worship idols again. You know what happened to them? Peace now came back to Judah in the time of Asa. Do you know what happened to Asa? His own mother, the queen mother, had an altar of idol. Asa became angry, and he dethroned his own mother from being a king, from being a queen, and then cut off the altars of her mother. And then Israel entered into a time of peace. So if we are doing charms, do you know, sir? So surprising that even pastors don't even trust this God I'm talking about. Even pastors. The other time, some pastors were traveling, and this pastor, he told me one story of, I don't want to call the name of organization, one of their registrar, they have a Bible school, big Bible school in Jos. The registrar, I think registrar was the person, the registrar was traveling, and then they went to Abuja to pick some white men that came. And then they were now going back to Jos with the white man. And while they were coming, Fulani attacked them on the road. And he wanted to run. Fulani shot him and he died. When he died and they drew him out, this man was wearing charm. I think he's a bishop. He says he's a bishop. A bishop was wearing charm on his waist. Charm. A bishop. The other time from Jos, they said some ministers of the gospel were traveling from Jos, I think, to Abuja. And their motor had accident. Reverend doctor from various evangelical churches had accident on the way. And then most of them died. I think only two or three survived. Do you know when they went to rescue them? Almost all of them were wearing charm on their waist. And brother, we want to fight against the Fulani. We want to succeed. Go to your church, go and ask. In our church, most of our youth are carrying rings. Most of them, you see them wearing different kind of ring. Those rings are what? They are charms. Most of the rings they wear. I saw one young man. You know, when we went to the camp yesterday in Benin, that young man, I didn't go there for any spirituality. That was why I didn't talk. That young man, the ring he wore was a satanic ring. Ring. There is a woman in Kaduna. She, one of our family friend in Kaduna, when we were in Kaduna, by Kaduna. The wife worked with this Planned Parenthood. So the woman came to the place to come and to come and check herself. So they needed to give her injection. So they carried the syringe and pierced her with the syringe to give her injection. The syringe refused to enter. They tried. All the nurses tried. The syringe refused to enter. They have tried and tried. Hey, so the woman too was tired. So he said, "Hey, I forgot." He said, "Please, she wants, let her remove this ring." God, her husband bought this ring for her from Saudi Arabia. And she removed that ring and said, "Okay, you should give her." They just come, PM, the injection enter, they give her injection. Ring. Ordinary ring. You think it's ordinary ring? Some of us that were here, some of our members in churches, they have gone to drink concoction. What they have they done? Some of them is concoction. They prepare some charms and they drink it. Once you enter them, they become what? They tell them that bullets cannot what? Enter you again. And you are happy. That bullet cannot enter again. We were in part of Plateau State when we went through this program in Bokos local government. The cooking minister there, the chairman of cooking was telling us this story. That when during the fight, one of their men, Fulani, came to attack. And then people were hiding and were fighting. The man went and carried his bulletproof, where they don't do for him. Carry and wear. The charm, where they do for the bulletproof charm, he wear him. The man just come. They come. People were trying to dodge Fulani so that they can see how to attack them. Because of the confidence of the bulletproof he had of charm, he was coming. And they said the Fulani only had one bullet left in their gun. Because they had been shooting. And they just faced that man. Bah! One bullet, and the man fell to the ground and died with all his charms. Some trust in horses, some trust in chariot. He said, "But we will what? We will trust in the name of the Lord our God." He said, "They are brought down, but we are still standing. We shall arise." Brethren, except Jehovah watch over a city, what happened? In vain the labor that watch over the city. As a matter of fact, one of the things we are saying, you can write this down. One of the things we are saying is that you must have vigilante, or you must set up a security structure in your lands. Very important. But your trust must not be in them. Our trust must be in who? In Jehovah, our God. Bible says, the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and they are what? And they are saved. One of the things that we have seen today is that we call God, we go to church, but we don't trust this God we are calling. So we do what? We call this God, but we don't trust this God again. From pulpit to the pew. So we have imported what? Charms. We have drank. In Kaduna, a pastor told a friend of mine, one of that pastor from different churches, who were discussing, he said, "Pastor, what is wrong now? I didn't go and bow down before any idol altar. I didn't go down to go and kill chicken. I only drank something. That should not be a sin now. If you have gone to drink anything for protection, you are what? You are an idol worshiper. You have polluted yourself." And the Bible says, keep yourself away from what? From idol. And if you remain a Christian, the church will be losing this battle. Some of our elders, some of our people, land, some of your people in the villages are using charm to farm. Some people are using charm to farm. And they are Christian, they use charm to farm. And you say there's no idol in your land. You cannot succeed. Our land needs to be purged. We are on this mission. The Lord asks us to go on this mission to go and raise Gideon in every city.
Gideon, Josiah, Isaac.
Who is a Gideon? A Gideon are men who will go and to their land and what and make sure that there are no altar, no idols worship in their land.
Just like Josiah.
And we are trusting God that the Lord will raise Gideon from this
and Josiah.
Those whom God will speak to and tell them, come. There is an idol somewhere in one place there. Go there and go and destroy it. God will start giving them revelations. And they will go and destroy it by night.
Yes, Lord.
We're talking about that God will open the eyes of our pastors and pastors can begin to see. People come to us, they say, you are carrying charm. In church, pastor will begin to tell them. And then people begin to what? Begin to purge themselves. Brethren, if you cannot purge ourselves, our churches and our land of idol, forget about the battle against the Fulani Caliph.
Like Josiah did.
Battle, they will win this battle. You know, there are 57 countries of the world that are called Islamic countries. Do you know that most of those countries today, they are formerly Christian countries, but today they are Islamic countries. If we must win this battle, what must we do? We must purge ourselves, then what? Our churches and what? And our land of what? Do you know that in church, sir, I met one pastor. He said before he gave his life to Jesus, it was difficult for him. Because his father was a Muslim and he's into these diabolic things. He said that elders used to come to him to do charm so that they can become church chairman. Elders come to Muslim man to do charm for them to become church chairman. Even the women used to go there to become women leader. They do and do charm to become women leader. Sir, it's happening. Pastors used to go and do charm to get promotion, to be posted to good churches. They will go and do charm to influence the people in the office so that when they have, they will come and tell them with charm, I want you to post me to this place. And the person will not refuse, you just post them. I have a young man told me this. He said that there was a charm they gave me at the point. That charm is, they gave me that charm. One of his own gave me that charm. That anywhere he comes, if he tell you, this is what I want you to do for me, you can never reject it. So many pastors have charms they use to remote their leaders. And you want God to fight for us? Can it work? It cannot work. The church has been grossly been compromised, has been polluted. So if we want God, and do you know what's happening? The Muslim are the one, they are the one that planned this thing. I was telling him, the pastor told me, do you know that there are some Muslim malams that used to go about from church to church, like especially in the Pentecostal churches and other churches, to tell pastor that we have charm to do for you. A pastor told me this, that a Muslim came to meet him, and a Malam, that he does charm. If you want charm for promotion, if you want charm for so that members can be coming plenty to your church, he has it, all category of charms, he has it. They are going about from church to church. Do you know their target? Their target is what? Because they understand what is called the principle of pollution. They want to pollute the church. Pollute the church? It's happening. Pastors collect charm for Muslims. We heard in Plateau that even in Kaduna State, that most of the people that are going about from village to village to do charm for Christians, for protection, they are Muslims. Why they are fighting us? The Muslims have what? They have strategically released their people into our villages.
You refer...
Everywhere, they are going about doing charm for Christians for protection. Fulani are Muslims. Fulani come to kill you. A Muslim man come to your community. Tell them, I want to do charm for you so that you can what? You can protect you against Fulani. And the Fulani are coming to do jihad. Because in Islam, the idea is that in Islam, we have Islam divide the world into two.
God bless you. Refer to the next slide in Jesus.